Hello, Ray. This is Master Control. Winterset coming up on Monitor 4. Stand by. 5 seconds.
Okay, waiting for cue.
Go ahead, Winterset, Iowa.
This is Ray Geesie, and you are looking at Winterset, population 3,579, seat of Madison County, Iowa. In Winterset, the whole town's talking. Outside the farmers' co-op, Ralph Hamm is saying that if the town builds a new school, it's the farmers who'll have to pay for it. At the Production Credits Association, farm manager Helen Kellerher warned school superintendent Lillard that the country children will suffer if their one-room schools are closed. But when Ed Barr comes to town, he agrees with implement dealer Henderson that if the country people and the town people want the best education for their children, they're going to have to do something, and do it together. January 24, 1952, to Winterset, Iowa, scene of a town and country school problem, comes television to catch the face and voice of America itself. This is the Winterset School, which serves the children of Winterset and 244 tuition-paying students from the neighboring rural districts. It is a good school, but the people of Winterset want to make it better. They cannot do this without the help of their neighboring farmers. Within the next hour, before the eyes of the television cameras in this music room, their children and neighbors watching them at home, and the entire 250,000 viewing audience of WOI-TV, these 12 farm citizens from 11 rural school districts around the town of Winterset will make a symbolic decision in this, the fourth in a series of television reports on day-to-day developments in Iowa's critical school problem. They will decide whether to accept or reject Winterset's plan for a single, large town and country school district with a single tax and equal representation for all. Guiding them for the whole town's talking will be Ralph Imes, clergyman from Eldora, Iowa.
Representation, if you go into this consolidation plan, you will have a school board which will represent you. You're now on the tuition basis. Remember, two issues, stay put or consolidate. We have to get it somewhere within that framework. Now, it will mean that if you move for a better education, it's going to cost you more money.
This afternoon, before free discussion and argument, a secret ballot taken by these 12 on this issue was to stay put, 5, to consolidate, 7. At the end of this program, to inspire town and country to take steps leading to an official, democratic decision on Winterset school problem, they will vote again. And while they are voting here, their neighbors watching this program in Madison County will also vote on the special Whole Town's Talking ballot prepared and distributed by the Winterset Madisonian to each of its 3,725 readers. Pressing these buttons on the tables in this Winterset schoolroom, each of the 12 will light up his choice on the vote board. When Kenneth Speerah makes his decision, he'll be thinking of his life spent on an Iowa farm and of the children he is raising to take his place. There's his daughter Shayon, 6 years old, and her teacher, Miss Perkins. Shayon gets a lot of personal attention and good moral training in this one-room country schoolhouse. It's 1.75 miles from Speerah's farm, but his daughter doesn't have to walk down the country road or through the fields to get to and from school. Her father sees to that. Every morning, Kenneth Speerah drives his daughter to school, and every afternoon, he leaves his chores to call for her. When he was a boy, Kenneth Speerah's father made him walk to school. It taught him the value of education. When Shayon gets older, she's going to have to walk to school, too, on nice days when a walk down a country road is an adventure and an education. But until that time, Kenneth Speerah would rather leave his work in the field and take care of his daughter himself. For the most important thing to Kenneth Speerah is being close to his children and being able to lead them to an understanding of the things he values in life on a farm: hard work, self-reliance, independence. These are the things he wants for all the children. whether they live in town or in the country. And these are the things he teaches his son John as they do their chores together, so that after John goes through his rural school and the high school in Winterset and a college somewhere, he will want to return to the good life his father is working so hard to prepare for him on an Iowa farm. Kenneth Speerah shares this feeling with many others. Men twice his age have the same love for the rural life. Ollie Holland got his land the hard way. First a farmhand, then a teacher. It took him 35 years to save the money to buy this farm. Now at 73, he's not too old to do the daily chores he's done for 40 years. For the first time, he and his wife, Mabel, are thinking seriously of leaving the land, moving to town, retiring. It's not easy for a 73-year-old man and his wife to work on a 250-acre farm with no children or even a hired man to help them out. But it's hard to leave the life they've known for 40 years. Though they are alone now, they raised four children on this farm, saw them born here, work here, play here. Ollie Holland cannot forget the sight of his children playing with this sled or walking through the pasture land, through the mud, 2 miles to a one-room country school. Ollie Holland cannot forget these things, even though they happened 40 years ago, because today they're still happening. Through the same fields, over the same roads, through the same mud, walk the children of his district to the same one-room rural school. They came here, they walk here, to receive, says Ollie Holland, an inadequate, outdated, backwoods education, an education unable to prepare these children for the world they must face. That's why Ollie Holland is interested in the school problem, not for himself or for his own children, but for these young faces who cannot speak for themselves, who will not know what their education has given them or not given them until it is too late. It is for these children of today and tomorrow that Ollie Holland has come here to speak his mind.
And this is the way, now remember, this is the way that you people are going to make your symbolic decision tonight. Now what do you think, Mr. Holland, of this proposed plan of Winterset? Of this Winterset plan here, what do you think of that?
I think that I'm entirely in favor of it, Mr. Holland.
You're entirely in favor of it? Well, just why are you?
Well,
you know, everybody
I want to make this proposition that I think you will all agree with, and that is that we are all in favor of the very best education for our children that we can possibly give. Now, is there any opposition to that? Mr. Speerah, are you opposed to that?
No, sir, I'm not.
And here's another proposition, that we are all agreed that the old country school is no longer the place where that can be achieved. How do you agree with that?
That's a difference of opinion.
Well, even the best of teachers cannot overcome a lot of the disadvantages that we find in our country schools. In the first place, many of them don't have enough enrollment to make classes in which there can be competition and that can make it interesting for the students. Our superintendent, Mr. Smith, has said that half of the pupils in the county are in classes of 1 and 2. Now, what kind of competition can you have in a class of 1 or 2? In the second place, a teacher goes into a rural school, she may have as high as 9 grades if she's got the kindergarten. Many of them have 8 grades. Now then, suppose that we limit 1 grade to 5 classes, but there are quite a number of grades that have more than 5 classes. 5 times 8 are 40, and 5 times 9 would be 45. Classes that the teacher has to call up to the rostrum and hear every day. That's an impossible task. No teacher can do that and do justice. 6 or 7 minutes for 1 class period. In town, they may have an hour with only 1 grade to the teacher. Why, it's ridiculous. In this day and age of atomic bombs and automobiles, we're way back in the old horse and buggy days. Now, there are reasons why we'll have to change our plan of education. The old country school is dying out. It's on its last legs. I can show you here on this chart.